coronaviruses are viruses that generally attack the respiratory tract. They're similar to influenza, and there are a number of different coronaviruses, some of which we have routinely here in the United States. But over the years, we've seen these novel coronaviruses, starting with SARS several decades ago. More recently, that started in Asia. Then we had MERS, which we still have, starting in the Middle East. And more recently, just at the end of December, a new novel coronavirus called 2019 novel coronavirus originated in Wuhan, China. It causes a flu-like illness. You really can't distinguish it from influenza. So in most patients, fever, cough, and shortness of breath would be the initial symptoms, and it could progress to pneumonia or more severe respiratory disease. In terms of the novel coronavirus, if you have those symptoms and you've been in China in the last 2 weeks, then again, stay home, but first call your healthcare provider and talk to them about the symptoms. And if you're having severe illness, then you would need to be seen, but you should call ahead. These respiratory viruses, not only the novel coronavirus, but influenza and others, are spread first by droplets, that is by people coughing and sneezing, generally within 6 feet, and certainly by direct contact, meaning touching hands and then touching your nose without performing hand hygiene. We don't really know exactly what the risks are. That's because we don't really have an estimate of how many people have been infected. So we don't know what percentage of people will go on to have severe disease, severe pneumonia, sepsis, and die. But certainly people have died of this virus, as do for flu and other viruses. This virus is distinct microbiologically, that is under an electron microscope, or the way you grow it. It's not at all related to influenza, but in terms of symptoms, it's exactly the same. First of all, it's not too late to get your flu shot. Flu is a much bigger risk, particularly in the United States, than this virus, so go get your flu shot. Second of all, if you're sick and you have any respiratory virus, stay home and don't infect the rest of your colleagues and friends. If you are outside, you follow what we call respiratory etiquette, which means if you're coughing and sneezing, take a tissue and cover your nose and your mouth. That dramatically decreases the spray of these infectious droplets and reduces other people's risk. And then finally, hand hygiene, because many people touch their face quite commonly. So whenever you touch your face, or if you're out in public, perform hand hygiene. Simple soap and water works perfectly well. If not, any of the FDA-approved alcohol antiseptics will work perfectly well. This is what we call an envelope virus. It's not particularly stable, and so it can be removed from the hands by good hand hygiene. And if you are sick and you do have to come into a healthcare facility, ask to get a mask and put that on, and try and sit 6 feet away from other people again so you don't transmit the virus.